Well, I'm Matt and this is John. We're from Larva Labs and we have written several applications for Android. We have three games and a photo twisting application, and we wrote them because mainly because we're fans of the genres they're in: a strategy game, a tower defense game, and a word kind of finding game. So that was really the motivation, and just because we like the platform as well.
So you chose the Android platform. Tell us a bit about how you came to that decision from a technical standpoint.
Yeah, I think, well, we're Java developers from sort of way back, so we chose the Android platform, you know, because we really liked the SDK and we kind of liked where they were going with it, liked that it was open source and that it was so sort of pluggable and you know, open in its access. So it seemed to really make sense for us. And we wanted to target the, you know, the market, wanted to try that out and see if there was a business there in, you know, in targeting the Android market.
So as developers, we really value being able to share war stories. So tell us about one particularly difficult period of development and how you dealt with that.
It's a good example of that.
let me think here. Well, I would say we had a little bit of trouble on our tower defense game, Retro Defense. We had some trouble kind of getting, there's a lot of graphics in that game, there's a lot of animation and a lot of stuff, and you know, we spent a lot of time kind of just getting it to the level of performance that we wanted to get it to. So it wasn't necessarily there was any one particular stumbling block per se, but it was just kind of a process of optimization that, you know, kind of led to some unexpected things we did. You know, that weren't necessarily obvious. So I would say again, like, I think everyone knows the advice, but profile to know what you're doing before you start doing it, because we definitely wasted a bit of time fixing some things.
We also had a real struggle on the app where you're warping photos. We wanted to be able to get photos from the gallery and put photos back into the gallery, or be able to email them out. And you know, we knew about the intents and we thought it was going to be kind of a straightforward thing, but we really struggled to do that. We really kind of we searched every possible forum post and tried all these different things, and we eventually got it to go, but that was a real battle to, you know, and I think now that we know it, you know, we know it forever, and the next time we do something even similar to that, it'll go a little better, but that was a struggle. Yeah, just sort of working between the gallery app and the and our app, and between the email app and our app.
It seemed almost like the things that we thought were going to be hard weren't hard, and the things we thought were going to be easy turned out to be a little more difficult. It was not in every case, but a few of those things, that's what happened. So
yep.
So what new features in Cupcake have you been able to use in your application?
What new features? Well, one new feature we were able to use is not crashing. because we had a bit of a problem. So we fixed that now, that's good. But yeah, not too much. I mean, what was kind of cool about that was that a lot of our interface just kind of took advantage of it automatically. Like, we have a bunch of cool transitions now where we didn't before, which kind of just worked without us doing anything. So the whole interface of our games, like the way the settings come up and the way when you pop open the new level chooser and stuff, it's all like smooth, like cool kind of 2D transitions and stuff. So that was really, really nice to run that for the first time once we fixed the crash and see all those new transitions. So
we don't have anything like this in an app that's out yet, but we're interested in getting involved in the new sound APIs too, and the more direct access to audio. That's something that's interesting to us for sure, and we hope to use that more.
Okay. Were there any tips or tricks that you were able to use in your app?
Tips or tricks that we heard, that we learned from someone that we made use of. I mean, there.
There's a few. Yeah, there's a couple. One was this gesture detector class is awesome.
Yeah.
Where we were writing a bunch of stuff to try to figure out when you're long pressing. We just didn't really realize there was something already in there for flings, for all that kind of stuff like that you would do with touch interface. This thing handles it all and just kind of gives you this super nice interface into, like, the user just flung in this direction, you know, the user long pressed this thing. So that thing was, we spent some time trying to do it ourselves, and then we realized that was there and it replaced everything we did with that. So that was really a good find.
Yeah, and there was with the existing audio stuff, the sound pool stuff, you know, how to use that. We struggled for a while on that.
Yeah, that's true.
There was limited documentation, but some sort of some forum posts and stuff sort of straighten us out.
Oh,
on
yeah,
that.
The audio tip is use Ogg Vorbis. It's the only one.
That's right. Yeah.
I mean, pre Cupcake. I don't know what the deal is on Cupcake yet, but
yeah, we just had you know, wave files, just unencoded audio, and it had a lot of latency. And then we just sort of, someone just mentioned almost in passing, like, is Ogboris the only format that has no latency? And we said, what? And so we switched over to that, and everything's real sharp and working great.
Yeah,
so that
was a good tip.
Yeah, that was a tip that came out of nowhere for us, yeah.
So what's your favorite aspect of the Android development process?
I would say, the SDK is great. The emulator is really good, and I would say like having the source is amazing. We haven't worked on a phone before where we've had access to the source, so there's a lot of times where you have a very simple question about what something's going to do, and the way we did it before was black box, you know, like test every possible thing until it did something right. Now you just take a look, you know, and it's very quick. It's to see what's going on. It saves a lot of time. So
yeah, that's really handy. That's a big factor. Yeah.
And we're getting more into like the kind of the replaceable aspect of the components, you know, intents and stuff like that, and access to all the different information on the phone. And so that whole content provider system is really cool too. So the kind of open nature of all the components in the phone is really, I think, going to provide some concrete benefits. You know, it's not just going to be a talking point. It's going to start to produce some real, real cool results.
So what are features that you can do in your app that you can't do on other platforms?
Well, like Matt just said, there's things that we can't do are the on other platforms is that sort of real integration with other components. You'd be able to pull data out from other apps, from your contacts or from SMS or phone calls, all that sort of stuff. You can build an app that truly is like a first class member of that phone, and not just some add on that is of that's completely sandboxed and unable to participate. That's a big thing.
So thank you for your time.
Yeah.
All right, perfect.